At least they don't pay him anything for it. I'm sure they don't pay him anything. So that's envy. Envy comes out like that. You know, it just minimizes it. And the other way around, if there's love, then the mother for a little child, you know, and anything a child does, the child sneezes or something like that. Oh, isn't that nice? Isn't that cute? I don't know, it's just a dirty child, you know. My mother would say, oh, just, you know, hear how he speaks, you know. Isn't that wonderful, you know, how he speaks? Look at the first teeth. Oh, isn't that nice? Others will know nothing, you know. What are you talking about? But actually, love makes you appreciate good qualities and the activities and so on. It's actually nothing else but love. So if we're envious, then, you know, I just saw you distribute whole seven books on the street. And I feel pains. Why was it me? I'm here. You know, I couldn't just do anything. You just do so nice. I'm just burning in the inside. And, that's envy. I should be happy. You know, Krishna is, you know, Krishna's service is happening. But I'm not. And that's, you know, that's a symptom of enviousness.
Radha Natsram, he also in the he said also that if someone's hurt, and then you feel sorry for the person who's hurt.
Mm.
But if this person is fortunate, it's even more of a challenge.
Yeah.
You feel happy for him,
yeah.
But he's in a fortunate situation.
Yeah.
He also said once you turn envy, he had many like hatred to love and things like that. And envy, he said, rather from it.
Mm.
He said we should turn to compassion.
Okay.
I was thinking about that and compassion. Okay, if you're envious of a great soul, then you should turn that to compassion.
Yeah, but not compassion for him.
Hmm?
You don't feel compassion towards someone superior, except compassion is something you feel towards someone in an inferior position.
It means that actually when one doesn't show compassion, one is like envy also.
Yeah, but one actually likes to push others down. He's happy that they push down because that makes me better.
Mm. Yeah, Bhaktivinoda Thakur said this, that devotees paras. Sukha, he's not like happy when something always happens. And he takes pleasure in it. And what the Prabhupada said about this envy to the great soul, turn it into compassion. Like Prabhupada said, this disease is there, but where should we? Oh, how to...
When it's someone who is a great soul...
I didn't finish, but...
Obviously, it's wrong. Okay. That if it's someone superior to you, you feel very happy that you have the association of someone like that, a great soul. You're just happy.
Yeah.
And if it's an equal, you also feel very happy for him and you just cultivate friendship.
Oh, I just thought that... that we should feel compassion toward our own self to see that we are envious toward that person. We should feel compassion toward our own self that I'm so low that I feel this kind of stuff. And Prabhupada writes in the Bhagavad Gita in one of the purports that self-realization is the compassion for our own is the compassion for our own self that we are so full of. It can be applied in the same way.
And you can, as a great soul, you can pray for his mercy somehow, so I can get over my enviousness and my low mention by your mercy.
And it's an amazing effect when actually, yesterday we were on the walking street, and it's such an amazing effect that to be standing there and people there not interested in what you're doing and you're trying your best and you're being so humiliated, you feel so stupid. And in the end, you kind of feel really disgusted also with yourself, but you kind of project it towards them and you just say, bah, they don't deserve it. They don't deserve it, you know. So, they don't get it today. I don't care. But then, that, that one just stays there.
Yeah.
And it turns, actually. It's amazing that it turns. Around. It doesn't stay for very long, but just to see that it happens. That
it's most beautiful. Okay, I think we have to stop here.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay. Okay.